The last event on the track at the London Olympics always shaped as a battle between Jamaica and the USA for overall sprint supremacy. The Americans had taken a back seat to their great rivals until the US women's 4x100 relay team shattered the long-standing world record. Now, it was the men's turn. With Justin Gatlin and Tyson Gay in their foursome, the US went in confident against a Jamaican squad that had lowered the record for this event at the Beijing Olympics, then again at 2011's World Championships. So the scene was set for excitement.
Set.
And it was the USA away quickest, with Trell Kimmins establishing a lead over Jamaica's Nesta Carter by the first change. Gatlin ran a strong second leg for the US, while Michael Frater struggled to stay in touch. Then on the final bend, Yohan Blake blew Tyson Gay away to hand Usain Bolt a narrow lead over Ryan Bailey. The crowd and the clock told the rest of the story. Another new world record to Jamaica, taking 0.2 of a second off the old one, with the USA close behind, then well over 10 metres to Canada in third, though the Canadians would later be disqualified for leaving their lane, elevating Trinidad and Tobago to bronze medal position. But this night was all about Jamaica, the kings of sprinting, led by the incomparable Usain Bolt. And so the athletics program at London 2012 came to a close with the medal ceremony for the men's 4x100 metre relay. Victory once again to Jamaica in another world record time. The silver medal to the USA, also running a national record. And the bronze medal to Trinidad and Tobago.
Well, you know, this is our third one, and being a part of the team is something really great. And you know, handing over to Michael and to Michael to Blake, Blake to Bolt. We was expecting a fast time, but 38, 36, 84 is really fast.
Michael, how special is this for you?
I mean, it's an awesome feeling. Breaking a world record is always a good feeling, especially doing it at the Olympic Games. I think there's no bigger audience who could have done it before. So I just have to go out there, just give God thanks. My family and friends, all the support they gave me. And you know, it's just a wonderful feeling that we're feeling right now.
And Yohan Blake, what does it mean to get your first Olympic gold medal?
It has been good. First and foremost, I have to give the guys them thanks. Nesta, Michael, Usain, God, it has been good. You know, I can't complain. Two silver, two gold. I feel great. I'm feeling wonderful.
Usain Bolt, three golds. How special have these Olympic Games been for you?
Very special for me. It's been a great honor, and I'm very happy with what I've done. And it's just amazing. It was just a good feeling.
How good is this quartet out here?
Without a doubt, we done it last year, and we just do it again pretty much. We just bettered the record, and it was an honor to finish on this note. Is just a wonderful feeling.
And what do you want to achieve in your career now for the man that's had it all?
Well, I don't know. I have to make different goals. This was my major goal to become a legend. I've done that. So right now, I'm gonna go home. I'm gonna sit. I'm gonna think about it.
Man, it was just a blessing. You know, we have had some knickknacks in the past. It was just a blessing to get to stick around the track. We all had faith in one another, and we got the job done.
How electric was that race?
That's all it was electricity. You know, it was just the energy coming from the blocks. Trell gave me the stick. I wanted to give enough room for Tyson to get around the curve. He went out there and did a great job, and Bailey brought it home. So it felt good. We have a national record. I love that.
And Tyson, what does that national record mean to you?
Man, it means a lot, man. I'm just glad we got the record, man. It's another record that we got. We're going for 36 next year, and it means a lot.
And Ryan, you finished it off. How tough was that final leg?
It was tough. Like, a lot of pressure, but, you know, they did a great job and gave me enough room to be able to run relaxed and run safe, so it was good.
We put our hearts into it, and this was my most toughest team and toughest decision, because while I was warming up, my leg was cramping. I almost pulled out, you know. But my team trusted me. They didn't worry. You know, they say warm up, and as we go through, we decide. But it's a wonderful feeling. The Lord is working in a mysterious way. So I can't even explain this feeling, no? We came and we get back home. In 2008, we came second. But as I say, and I told my team, I don't care how I get it, once I get it. So I'm happy, and I'm thanking the Lord.
And what was it like to be a part of the fastest race in history?
It was a good feeling, but as my teammate said, we know what was on the line. We had an adjustment to make, and you know, we went back to our original team in Beijing, and with the DQ, you know, that thank God for that. You know, we did our part, and you know, the results did the rest.
Emmanuel, what about you? What are your emotions on an extraordinary night here?
Well, I'm really happy and excited to actually come onto the world stage again and obtain a medal for Trinidad and Tobago. The race itself, it was phenomenal, and we were sure we were in third, but we didn't know what the other country was. So we're just happy to get a medal right now.
And Richard, what about your thoughts on tonight and the whole London experience for you?
The London experience has been extremely good for me. Trinidad and Tobago has been doing extremely well as well. And, you know, we crossed the line, realized we were fourth, and we just went to two extremes. We were extremely sad. And then when we realized we were third, we were ecstatic.